violation. Oh. We'll call a 3-second violation.
Oh.
And here's a fast break opportunity. Limit again, anchoring the fast break for 2 points.
Oh, limit again. And he threw a foul.
But they're going to count the basket.
They'll
count
it.
That's right. They'll count the basket, but it'll be the third personal foul slapped on Libet. So we'll have to watch it from now on.
It's an offensive foul committed by Libet, but he converted the shot. And it's counted.
Yes, it is counted. With 13 minutes to go, Libet already with 3 personal fouls.
Letran on top by 6 points. Kimball on the offensive for the Stags. Passing it to Hutton. Hutton against Salazar.
Another 3-second violation. Another fast break in the offing for Letran.
Could be a jump ball. That's Alvarez and Pina.
And the Knights very quick to exploit the opportunity to score. Every time there is a turnover, as you see Francis Rodriguez there on your screens, every time there's a turnover that's slapped on Francis Vassell, Letran quick to exploit the situation and start their own fast break.
Okay, we have Paul Alvarez, who stands 5'11", against Pinat, who stands 6'2". Ball tapped by Alvarez to Kilban. Kilban almost losing it, but recovers. Alvarez now for a jumper, and it's good.
Well, he had to suspend himself in midair for that one. He had to elude the Letran defender there, suspending himself in midair before taking off for that shot. Paul Alvarez now gives Letran only a 4-point lead, cutting down that deficit further.
Yes, and we have Ison now on the offensive for the Letran Knights. Ison goes to the paint, goes outside, passing it to the Pinat now. From the 3-point area, passes inside to Salazar. Salazar harassed by Hutton.
Another miscue. Here we have another fast break opportunity.
Hutton cutting down the lead of Letran to 2 points, 70-68. Letran on top by 2, 12:26 to go, final half.
And this is definitely an uprising if we ever saw one.
That's right, Kinito, and we have Pinat now.
Double-teaming.
It's double-teamed. The brief for a jumper, but he was fouled in the act of shooting by Arthur De La Cruz.
Well, David was wide open on the baseline there, and the San Sebastian offense was on the strong side. He was all alone in the weak side, got the pass, went up for a jumper, and Arturo De La Cruz had no recourse but to try to stop him with a foul.
A duty foul committed there by Arturo De La Cruz. 70-68, 12 minutes, 14 seconds to go in the final half. We have the beat converting the first charity. Second round of the bid is good. 2-for-2 from the line by Khabib, and that increased the lead of Letran to 4 points in the lead. Kilban now. Guarded by Arthur Ison, he passes it to Hutton. He might go inside, but passing it outside to Terrace. Alvarez now from the 3-point area. It's an air ball.
Oh, excellent behind the back dribble there. A good assist by Ison.
Very nice pass by Pinat.
Passing play between Pinat and Ison. But credit that play to Ison's expert ball handling.
And we have Hata now. Outside pass to Alvarez. Kimban saving that pass from Alvarez.
Letran defense forcing San Sebastian to take the shot from outside. Here's the penetration.
We have a foul there by Alberto David of Arturo De La Cruz.
And somehow San Sebastian cannot seem to wrest that lead from Letran. Twice they pulled very, very close by just 2 points. But somehow the Knights have come back, stretched that lead even further.
Yes, and Letran is ahead by 6 points right now. But Arturo De La Cruz might be able to cut down this lead.
De La Cruz with 9 points. So far, scoreless in the second half.
Oh, he misses. Another bonus shot to be given to Arturo De La Cruz, who was fouled in the act of shooting there earlier.
And De La Cruz, 7 points missing again. Missing 2 from the line.
violation by Arthur Ison. He stepped on the sideline.
A lot of turnovers now being slapped in both clubs.
This is Paul Alvarez to the inbound. Kilban. Going up against Arthur Ison, and we have Hato now from the keyhole area. Goes to the right. And he misses.
But the ball will stay in the possession of the Redshirts.
Yes.
That was actually a poor shot by Hatton. Again, he did not have room, but he forced the shot.
He'll bunt for the penetration, but he misses. Follow-up shot by Tevez. No good. Another rebound by Tevez. No good again. Alvarez now. With a fourth try on the basket. And it's good. And he's good foul.
I think that's all the foul in Salazar.
Yes.
Those were three golden opportunities for San Sebastian to score from underneath the basket, but finally Alvarez consummating.
Alvarez, the light of the stars at this point.
Already with 31 big points.
74-68, the Toronto top by 6 points with 10:53 to go in the final half.
So you might say, Ron, that this is a Wong and Dong show. Wong Alvarez scoring 31 points so far,
and
Dong Libet with 29 for Letran.
This is a scoring duel for both players. And so far, Alvarez is ahead with 2 points over Dong Libet. Paul Alvarez.
12 of 14 so far from the line, 86%. And 9 of 18 from the field.
Should San Sebastian win this title, Alvarez might be voted the most valuable player.
Alvarez getting his own miss.
Oh, follow-up shot from under the basket by Hatton, but he misses.
Oh, and Alvarez still managed to get the ball.
He'll keep ball possession. The ball was tapped outside by Letran.
Alvarez already with 14 rebounds.
Alvarez now to Hatton. Oh, a technical foul. Called against.
I think it might have been David. You see him now on your screen? Shaking his head, telling the referee, he didn't really mean what I said.
A very costly violation there for the Letran Knights.
I think we also have to credit the crowd now. I think the fans from both Transitional and Letran have toned down.
Yes.
I think during the halftime break, as you were mentioning, Ron, there was an appeal for sobriety and for calm. I think the students from both schools have responded very well. The bands, in fact, have stopped playing. I think that has also somehow contributed to the toning down of emotion. So we're here to watch a good classic championship basketball game, and we're being treated to a fine show by both these teams.
That's right, and there are no more firecrackers at this point.
That's right.
We have the lapels now.
The only fireworks are the ones being shown us by these 10 players in the court.
Yeah. 2-for-2 from the line by De La Cruz, and that cut down the lead of the Letran to 2 points.
And this is the third time that San Sebastian has whittled down the lead to only 2 in this second half.
They haven't tasted the lead so far. Peanut now against Alvarez.
Oh, we spoke too soon about those firecrackers.
This is Ison passing it to Peanut. Peanut inside to Monte Aquino, back to Peanut now, harassed by Alvarez. Ison is open, but he misses a football.
A good boxing out there.
Alvarez, yes.
De La Cruz boxing out the opposition from controlling that rebound, and Paul Alvarez just snaring sky high to get the defensive rebound.
Eugene Kilban now controlling the ball for the Stags. Back to Hatton now. Hatton goes inside. It's a pass to De La Cruz who converts.
And we have a tied ball game run.
This is the second deadlock in the ball game. The first one was a 2-all, and this is only the second time.
This is incredible. What a comeback by San Sebastian. And they're showing what it takes to be a championship ball team.
Yes, and we have Salazar now inside the paint. But a foul is called against Dr. Tevez. We readily acknowledge that call by the referee.
We were just handed a piece of paper here. This is actually the third deadlock. We had a deadlock of 2-all, 6-all, and now 74-all. But gosh, a long time from fits all.
Yeah.
We have this third deadlock. So incredible comeback here by San Sebastian, showing what it takes to play the game both ends of the court. Good defense on one end and better shot selection on the other. But Letran needing to keep its composure this time. Tables are turned.
We have eyes on now, to Aquino, one to Aquino. Well, gives it inside to Salazar, but a foul away from the ball.
You know, I think the absence of Dong Liben in this ballgame has also told them tonight, because their firepower has slackened.
He just said it, and Liben is recalled to the court,
well,
sent back to the court.
He had to sit out a few crucial minutes there because of three personal fouls, but he's back in harness now.
Yeah. Aquino is back on the bench. He was replaced by Doc Liebert. Liebert now receiving that pass from Alisson. Liebert, he might go inside, but he makes an inside pass to Ruiz, who converts.
Liebert immediately making his presence felt there with a perfect assist pass.
And the Fun Knights back on the driver's seat, 76-74, 8:51 to go. Hakon, back to Kilban. Kilban goes inside. But the ball was snapped out by Dong Liebert. And the Stans will keep ball possession. 8:45 to go in the final half. This is a do-or-die battle between the top two collegiate teams of the NCAA. Kilban to Hatton. Hatton now back to Kilban. Kilban takes a three-pointer. Missing. Oh! Almost intercepted there. Interception completed by Bocha, and he passes it to Hakon for a jumper. It's good. 76.
Yes,
this is
the fourth.
The fourth deadlock at 76 all.
One-on-one action now. Salazar taking matters into his own hands.
Oh, a powerful rebound there by...
And he got poked in the eye. Oh, and the Stags rest the lead. They now have the lead 78-6. 78-76.
That's because of Rochester's conversion. The first
fans are wild.
Don't leave it now. This is collegiate basketball at its best.
Oh, definitely at its finest, Ron.
Brought to you by San Miguel Corporation.
We're being treated to some fine action here. A lot of hustle being shown by the players of both teams. San Sebastian, of course, seeking to be the fourth team to win back-to-back titles in the post-war era. As we have this timeout,
this is game number three, the final game between these two teams. We have Peanut inbounding to Aison. Aison now to Jerry Ruiz, back to Aison. Inside pass to Peanut, who makes a turnaround shot, misses. Rebound to Salazar. Another turnaround shot by Salazar is good. 78 all.
And that's the fifth deadlock of this ballgame.
That's right, and the Stags faced the lead only for a few seconds. Hatton now from the keyhole area against Salazar. Might go inside. Shot is short. A foul is committed by De La Cruz.
And he's down on the floor, breaking out into a wide grin. A little exasperated.
He must be a little bit tired now.
And both teams now with 17 fouls.
78 all is the count, 7:07 to go in the final half. And the Tran will inbound with Peanut there, passing it to Aison. Arthur Aison now against Eugene Kilban. Fernando Navarro, the other court general, is not being used here by Coach Rodriguez.
That's right, he hardly had any playing time.
Yes. Right, we have another foul there committed by Rocha. And that's the 8th team foul for San Sebastian. We have a timeout, direct Bronx Arena, the South Memorial Coliseum. The count is 78 all, and it's 6:52 to go. The final minutes of this exciting game between Letran and San Sebastian, and we have here
Jerry Ruiz on
Jerry
the line.
Ruiz, yes.
So far, 10 points in this ballgame, 4 of 8 from the field, and a perfect 2 of 2 from the free throw line.
He Ruiz missing on that first charity.
Ruiz standing 6'3" from a long upper city.
All right, a go-ahead basket.
11
for,
points.
The Letran Knights. 79-78, Letran on top by one. Kimbano the offensive for the Stags. Oh, the ball intercepted there by Ison, and he goes for an easy layup.
A one-handed layup there by Ison. Quick hands of Ison, perpetrating that steal.
81-78, Letran on top by 3 points. Kimbano now, to happen.
A little bit of a mental lapse there by the Stags.
That's right.
This time, the Letran defense again tightening up. Paul Alvarez being marked very well now on one end.
Rivera now for Jeffra. That's an offensive foul.
A bad break for San Sebastian, but a good call by the referee.
The shot is nullified, so the score stands at 81-78. It's caught on top by 3 points. We have a timeout called by Coach Francis Rodriguez. And we have Letran leading by 3 points. 6:08 to go. The final half, Ison on the offensive for Letran. Ison going up against Kimban, passing it now to Salazar. Cross pass to Livet, is tapped out by Melchor Temes.
A good breakup play there by Temes. Livet would have been open for a one-on-one opportunity on one side.
16 seconds on the shot clock. Peanut from the three-point area, misses. Rebound to Temes. Temes to Kimban.
Good attempt by Peanut, however, he broke out from a triple screen there. Liebet hauling down that rebound.
Peanut almost losing that ball. Liebet now at the three-point area. He might take a shot. Tevez harassing him. We have Peanut again.
And Letran chewing out the clock now. They feel time is on their side.
6 seconds to go on the shot clock. Ison, he might take a jumper. And he misses. Livet for the recovery. Oh. A foul spotted on Napoleon Hatton. That's the 19th foul.
And the powers of Letran continuing to assert their supremacy now under the boards. Jerry Ruiz combining beautifully with Cayetano Salazar and also Peanut.
Yes.
So the three of them really showing the way here in terms of grabbing those very crucial rebounds, giving Letran second, third attempt at the basket.
You can hear the loud cheers from the pro Letran crowd. This is Jerry Ruiz missing on that one.
11 points so far for Jerry.
Another charity shot for Jerry Ruiz. 81-78. A 3-point lead for the Letran Knights. 5 minutes, 7 seconds to go. It is do or die battle between these two teams. And he just converted the last charity. Oh, he'll be given another corner shot. There was a lane violation earlier.
So a chance to score 13 points for the night. Jerry Ruiz.
And Jerry Ruiz just gave the Con a 5-point lead. 5:05 to go. Eugene Kilban. Looking for the open man. Gives it to Hatton. Hatton harassed by tall man Cayetano Salazar. Hatton to Kilban. Kilban for a jumper, misses, rebound to Alvarez. But a foul. It's an offensive foul.
They're going to call it on Alvarez. Warding off with his arm to grab that offensive rebound.
And Alvarez commits foul number 3.
Oh, that was a painful call.
And the Letran Knights will be given charities.
Paul Alvarez also has been effectively silenced here for the last couple of minutes. He has been very well marked by Pinat.
We have a substitution on the side of San Sebastian. We have Arturo de la Cruz being sent back for action.
And time winding down. 4:44 to go. Pinat already with 10 points, 4 of 10 from the field, 1 of 2 from the line.
Pinat missing on that one-on-one situation. Move on to Alvarez. Kilda now. Bring down the ball. Passing it to Tevez. Yes, I pass De La Cruz, can't shoot.
A little tentative there on the part of De La Cruz. He might have had an open shot there, but he elected to pass the ball. The ball flicked away by Letran. Another attempt here by San Sebastian.
Kilda now. To Paul Alvarez. Paul Alvarez takes a turnaround shot but misses. Rebound won by Letran. This is Aison.
Yes, he was caught with a backing violation there.
Oh.
A little bit of color here between Alvarez and Aison. No, definitely not deliberate.
That was unintentional on the part of Alvarez.
And Alvarez and Aison embrace each other.
Alvarez, very cool.
But the Stags have to get their act together here if they want to overhaul this lead.
That's right.
And retain the title.
They're down by 5 points. Kilda now. Inside pass to Alvarez, who converts.
And it's a net goal situation. No foul call in that play.
83-80 is the count. The Stags trailing by 3 points. Full court press being applied by San Sebastian. Aiso now against Kilban, passing it to Postino Pinat. Pinat against Alvarez. A block there by Alvarez.
And they'll call a foul on Alvarez. That might be his fourth.
That could be. That's the fourth personal foul for Paul Alvarez with 3 minutes 29 seconds to go.
So that's bad news for the Stag. Alvarez so far with 33 big points and in danger of fouling up. Pinat back on the line.
Spino Pinat, also one of the top scorers for the Letran Knights.
Pinat is on his fourth year with the Letran senior team. He has played on 2 NCAA championship teams, the 6th of 8 children. Elder brother Sonny used to play for the Mapua Institute.
I think he's also one of the players being hired to play for a commercial team in the PABL.
Well, definitely the NCAA a farming ground for a lot of PABL ball clubs, and I'm sure also the PBA in the future.
We have Kilda now on the offensive for the Stags. Kilda against Aison. 3:17 to go. A foul away from the ball.
And they'll call it on De La Cruz.
Oh, Arturo De La Cruz.
So a series of bad calls going against San Sebastian in his closing minutes. And this series of bad calls could spell the difference. We have a timeout now being called by Letran.
We have 2 disqualifications now. One on De La Cruz.
We have a timeout, so we might have to return to our studio.
Salazar.
Salazar has been a bulwark on offense for Letran, backing up Libet with 14 points so far, 7 of 12 from the field.
Salazar misses on that one. Rebound control by Alvarez. Alvarez to Kilban.
So here's a chance for San Sebastian to rest the lead. Just a 1 point difference separating both teams.
Very close match being fought here by both squads. Alvarez now getting away from Pinat, but he's blocked by Montiel Pinat. Big foul for the follow-up shot. It's good. And they rest back the lead now.
And El Tintal coming out of nowhere, Ron, to put in those 2 points.
That's right.
Unlikely hero. Yes, unlikely hero.
Okay, we have have Arthur I saw now against Kilbane. Alvarez being marked by Lieber.
They'll call the foul now.
Oh.
Might have been called on...
That's Pinkal.
Pinkal.
Eric Pinkal.
So he has now figured in the last two plays of this ball game with 1:22 left. San Sebastian holding on to a very shaky one-point lead.
Pinkal had to be sent to the game because of the two disqualifications earlier by De La Cruz and Rocha, two tall players from San Sebastian.
And of course, Paul Alvarez in danger of fouling out with four personals so far. Pinat, 10 points in this ball game, missing the first. And he has been very unsuccessful from the free throw line run, 1 out of 6 so far.
He should be fouled more often by this time.
Right?
No, but he converts this time.
And
tying the count now,
84-0. And the sixth deadlock.
1 minute, 19 to go.
Well, this is really top-notch excitement that we're watching. Action-packed basketball, as only the NCAA can provide it.
They're happen now. Leader now for the rebound.
Less than a minute to go.
Pina against Paul Alvarez. Salazar now.
A double team by Juan Salazar.
Turnaround shot by Salazar is good. 86 to 84.
Coming through with that stop.
If Alvarez now losing that ball to leave it. They're running down the clock. 36 to go.
They might want to give up the foul here to put a stop to the shot clock. Oh, all alone. Monte Aquino.
Oh, another error there by San Sebastian Stags. 25 seconds to go. 88 to 84. The count on top by 4 points. Tevez.
Tevez keeping the hope of San Sebastian alive. It's still just a 2-point lead. Anything can still happen.
They need an interception here.
Or they need to make a foul. They need to put Letran on the line. They're not giving up the foul. The referees are not calling the foul.
2 seconds to go.
Oh. And Letran has won the
title. There goes the final war.
Letran has regained the title. Their ninth championship in the NCAA in 36 years. Dethroning the San Sebastian Stags.
That's right, Benito, and they've just become the winningest collegiate ball club in the NCAA.
So sweet revenge for Letran. The Knights were dethroned by the Stags last year, ending a streak of 3 straight titles. And San Sebastian came back to win the championship, and now it's Letran's turn. Their 4th title in the last 5 years.
That's right, and they've broken the deadlock with Ateneo. Ateneo also holds an 8 titles in the NCAA, when they used to play in the NCAA.
Well, definitely history making here from the Letran Squires. As you can see in your screen, the fans spilling onto the court now. The band's beginning to flare again. And let's have a word from our studios for the time being, and then we'll be right back.
Okay, a flag of appreciation to the members of the national basketball team who won a bronze medal in the recently concluded 10th Asian Games in Seoul, Korea. And the name of Alvin Patrimonio was just called. He's one of the recipients of that plaque of appreciation.
Well, the NCAA, of course, contributed several key players in that bronze-winning national team. Alvin Patrimonio being one of them, Sabonis being another.
Yes.
And congratulations are definitely in order for Coach Joe Lipa and his charges for defying all odds in bringing home the bronze medal. And it should have been a silver if not for that controversial call in the South Korea game.
That's right.
And if that call had gone to our favor, we would certainly have pocketed the silver and gone home in second place in the basketball tournament of the Asian Games.
That's Alvin Patrimonio, whose back is on the screen. They congratulated him by San Miguel officials led by Mr. Oscar Villarreal.
huge crowd here milling on the court. And the fans cheering. Some statistics. Ron?
Yes.
52% shooting for Letran as against 41% by San Sebastian. So much better shot selection. You see here the awarding ceremony is now being shown in screen. San Miguel officials led by Mr. Billy Dolid.
Individual medals now being awarded to players of the winning team, Letran Knights.
We see also on our screen is Sunny Valencia, who is the manager of the Magnolia basketball team in the PBA.
And Ms. Manchu Hanson, who is the special projects manager of San Miguel Corporation and an assistant vice president also of SMC.
I guess in the end, Ron, you have to say that because Letran was playing only two rookies as against seven for San Sebastian, experience made a difference. And in the end, experience led the Knights to hang tough. Avoiding whatever rallies that the Stags post, particularly in the final few minutes, the Knights holding on to that victory, and they were able to have superb ball handling, particularly from Ison Libet coming through with 29 big points, and the triple towers of Pinat, Salazar, and Jerry Ruiz combining forces to be able to control the rebound.
We'll take a look at the individual scores in that game. We have for the winning team, Letran, Libet now scoring with 29, Salazar 16, Ruiz 13, and Pinat 10. While Aquino has 8, Ison 6, and Anand 3, and Aviv 2. For the losing team, San Sebastian, we have Alvarez with a higher score, 35, Tevez 13, and Lacuz 13, Hatton 12, Rocha, and Avalo contributing 4 points apiece. Kilbar 3 and Vital 2.
And two players from the Stags lineup, of course, fouled out during the game, De La Cruz and Rocha. And Fernando Navarro, surprisingly, was hardly fielded in the second half. In the story of the rebounds, surprisingly also, Ron, the Stags dominated the boards, 39 rebounds against 29 for Letran. But really, it was in the field goal percentage. Letran coming through with 34 field goal conversions, 65 attempts, whereas San Sebastian coming through with only 28 out of 68 for a poor 41%. And you have to credit coach Eddie Reyes for the very tight defense that the Letran played throughout this ballgame. He has masterfully coached this ball club into a defensive type of a team, and somehow the Stags could not overhaul that.
And I think the experience also of the Letran Knights in the PABL helped a lot.
Oh, definitely.
Pressure
late again. Yes, San Sebastian, of course, also had its experience in the PABL in 1985. It finished the highest collegiate team.
That's right.
Sixth place in the first invitationals of the PABL.
And in the first conference of the PABL, the Letran placed second to UE in the collegiate in the Division B of the PABL.
So I guess that's the reason why both these teams showed us really fierce kind of basketball, very, very well played brand of ball game. Because both the Stags and the Knights have in fact polished their acts in the PABL. So a boost to amateur sports, a boost to aspiring collegians, collegiate players, all-star athletes.
Okay, we'll take a break for a while and we'll be back.